I was destined to have a unique upbringing when my dad decided to buy a house in a black neighborhood at the height of what was called white flight from South LA.
Whites don't buy houses in Compton anymore.
Yeah, my dad was crazy as fuck. I loved the music I heard growing up. My homies from around the way turned me on to Rick James, Cameo, the Daz Band. See, hip-hop had barely hit out west yet. It was an East Coast thing. In 1982, I heard Rapper's Delight, and needless to say, my mind was blown.
And my friends are gonna try to move your feet.
I started DJing when I was 18, and I cut my teeth grinding. Underground clubs, shitty parties, hustling gigs, promoting. I worked my way up from the bottom. Pretty soon, I formed one of the earliest street promotion companies.
You see the money? We make the money. We promote the records, G. PMP. We are pimping the music industry through street-level promotion.
Naughty by Nature, De La Soul, Queen Latifah, Brand Nubians, Leaders of the New School. I had an ear to the street. A great ear, man. I could hear a song from a block away and know if it was a hit. I discovered iconic West Coast artists, the Pharcyde, helped get Cypress Hill signed to Columbia. I ended up managing House of Pain. Ice Cube brought me on board to do marketing for his label. All of a sudden, this dude with crazy hair is standing in front of my desk telling me I'm gonna be his manager. That was Coolio. Anyway.
It was pretty unusual for, you know, a white guy to come in. He's in here, he must be somebody. Let's go outside, sit in the car, I'm gonna play it for you.
It played through the first verse and I ejected it.
He said, let me take the tape.
Warren Z, super producer.
That album literally saved Def Jam from going out of business.
Without Warren G, we would have had to sell the company. We would have fell apart.
I also brought Def Jam their first ever number one pop record, This Is How We Do It by Montel Jordan. And for all that, Russell Simmons and Lee Arcon from Def Jam straight up sued me. Some of the worst people I've ever had the displeasure of meeting were powerful entertainment execs. Let's just say I didn't want to go golfing with them. I'd much rather been with some of my friends playing basketball.
Growing up in Crenshaw has had an incredible effect on me. I was so blessed and accepted by people, which made me feel like I could always be that way in the larger urban community.
John Singleton, the legendary filmmaker, took me under his wing. He made me the music supervisor on his second film, Poetic Justice, and that led to a career which has included over 50 movies and TV shows. Insecure, Dear White People, Snowfall, Fast and Furious 2, Barbershop franchise, and Oscar-winning film, Hustle and Flow.
It's hard out here
for me, it's a business and a lifestyle. I can hold my head high because I've held to my word. I've held integrity with everyone I've ever worked with, and I've been blessed to work with some of the greatest. This is my story, a white boy from Crenshaw.
Paul Stewart.
White boy Paul Stewart?
Yeah, that's the guy.
He's a half nigga though.
Deliver DJ and Paul was his name. Deliver DJ and Paul was his name. Deliver DJ and Paul was his name. He came up to money, this is what he said. You and OG are gonna make some cash. Sell a million records and we're making the dash.